Hi there and welcome to this video. In this video, I want to tell you about some cheap storage VPS options that you can use if you need storage, if you need more storage for your VPS. There are certain providers that provide storage VPSs. Let's just get into it straight away. So number one, of course, you know, is Contabo. Contabo is one of the cheapest VPS providers. And if you want to see their storage VPSs, you're going to come here under VPS and then go to storage VPS. At least they use SSD for the storage, and that's a good thing. To see the prices, just scroll down here and you're going to see for 600 GB SSD. Please take note of SSD. So these are very affordable for SSD storage. If you need more storage, you'll have to jump to this one. And this is 16 euros for 1.8 terabyte SSD storage. So considering this is an SSD, you can actually run your website on that and you probably won't notice any reduction in performance. Those are the prices for that. Number one, as I've said, is Contabo. And I've used Contabo before, so that's why they're on this list. And then number two, I came across InterServer. So I haven't used their storage VPS, but if you want to see the price for the storage VPS, come here under Cloud VPS and then go to storage. So they're not SSD like Contabo, but these are the prices for that. So for $3, you get 1 TB HDD SATA. So all of them run on HDD. So that's the only difference between this and the other one. The speed, 10 gigabits per second. Contabo, 200 megabits per second port. All right, so there is the difference for you. So these are the two that I found that were straight VPSs with storage VPS, that is Contabo and InterServer. So other options, what you can do is you can get a VPS. For example, on Volta, you can get a VPS. And let's look at the pricing for VPSs. So if you want to come here on this page, just click on pricing on the Volta website. And then you can choose any regular performance VPSs. Let's say, for example, you want to go with that. So that will be $350, or you want one virtual CPU and 1 GB. That will be $5 per month. And once you get that, you can add a block storage. So let's look at the pricing for block storage. So if I click there on block storage, you're going to see they also have HDD block storage and NVMe block storage. So for the HDD block storage, $1 will give you 40 GB. For the NVMe ones, $1 will give you 10 GB. So depending on what you want to run, you can choose either of these options and attach it to your VPS. So that's one option. Volta has block storage that can be attached. DigitalOcean also has block storage that can be attached. Once you get your VPS, you can attach a volume block storage. For 100 GB, you get for $10 a month, you'll get 100 GB. So I believe these are NVMe as well, but you'd have to confirm with the documentation. But I don't think they would be charging this much for HDD. So it's probably NVMe. I'll put the links in the description. You can get $200 free credit of DigitalOcean if you want to use them, and Volta as well. I will provide a link for $300 of free credit if you want to use them. Another cloud option that you can also use with an additional volume or block storage is Hetzner. So once you get your cloud, your VPS server on Hetzner, and you can go there under servers, get your server, you can go to volumes, create a volume. So let's say I decide to create a volume. So 0.44, you'll get 10 GB. So this means that if you were to get like 1000 GB, that's going to be 44 euros per month, and that's going to give you roughly 1 TB. So something I read somewhere, and you'd have to confirm this, but I think it was in the documentation, that the volumes for Hetzner have a triple redundancy. This means that if you buy the 1 GB, it's like buying 3 GB because it will be replicated across three disks. That's something you also have to bear in mind. And this also NVMe, they're very fast storage. You can use them on a live server, on a live website, without any reduction in performance. If I was to get roughly the same, that would be like $25 of the HDD. And for this block storage, let's go to 1,000. So it will be exactly $100 per month. For Hetna as well, if you want to use them, I'll put a link. You can get 20 euros of free credit if you're new to Hetna. But creating an account on Hetna sometimes is difficult because they have so much demand that they probably try to decline as many people as possible just to reduce that. So the last option that I want to give you is not really a VPS. Okay, so this is an option on Hetna as well. If you want storage, you can get a dedicated server with additional disks added. So let's see the options. Let's say you want like 15 terabyte of storage. How much is that going to cost you? And let's look at, you just want storage. You don't want the best dedicated server. So come here under server finder to find a dedicated server that you can use. And I said I wanted something that's got at least 15 TB. So here under drives, if I scroll down here on this end, I can say I want a drive that's, let's just leave it there at maybe 6 TB. That's just to reduce the options that you get on this end. And at the same time, you can also say whether you want HDD, SATA, or SATA SSD or NVMe. That's an option, but I'm not going to drill down on that. Any option you see, it means that you can configure it and add an additional storage. For example, in this case, let me use this as an example, and I'm going to click there on configure. And by default, with this, you're going to get Ryzen 5 3600 64GB, and you're going to get two drives of NVMe, two 512GB NVMe, and this will be the boot drive. They will be in software read one. But you have to set that up if you watched my video of setting up Hetna dedicated servers. Now, the next thing that you'd have to change here is, and that is what brought us here, is the drives. So if you scroll down to the drives section, you can add an additional drive. Maybe you want two NVMe SSD. That will be $18 a month added to that. If you want SATA, you can, the SATA SSDs, you can get an additional 3.8 TB. At $48. Based on your budget, you can get whatever you need. You can get 16 terabyte of enterprise HDD at $27 per month. If you add that, you're going to get, for $69 a month, you're going to have 16 TB that you can use as an additional storage along with the boot drive. This is just an option I wanted to show you. Now, there are many possible options here. It's not just that. You can also get NVMe. For, I think NVMe goes up to 7 TB. So if you wanted one of those, you'd just have to keep searching and you'll eventually find one that matches what you need. Right? Just configure it to add the disks that you need. All right, that should be it. If you need help setting any of this up, just feel free to let me know. And I will add all the links in the description below. See you next time. Thank you.